knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Some of the most widely utilized reactions in organic synthesis are the olefination reactions. Over the next few tutorials, we will discuss some of the most popular name reactions associated with olefin synthesis. Olefins, also known as alkenes, can of course be made by a number of routes which do not involve skeletal changes, but simply refunctionalizations, like elimination reactions or redox reactions. Here, however, we will be talking about olefinations which involve skeletal construction steps. This can be represented as shown here. As we can see, two activated carbon units are joined in one reaction, although often by complex multi-step reaction mechanisms, to form a double bond that connects the two units. We may immediately recognize that one of the first name reactions we learned in this series, the Wittig reaction, is such an olefination reaction. We will likely recall that the product, in general, will exist as a mixture of E and Z alkenes. And indeed, one important theme in this area of research is E or Z selectivity, how to achieve it, and which parameters control it. We will begin with a reaction that is relatively recent, at least compared with many of the reactions we have been discussing in this series. This is the McMurray reaction, invented in 1974 by American chemist John McMurray of Cornell University in Ithaca, New York. In this particular case, with reference to the scheme previously discussed, both X and Y are oxygen atoms, and the McMurray reaction is the reductive coupling of two carbonyl compounds to yield an olefin. The reagent is usually a low-valent titanium species, which is generated in situ by some reducing agent. The first step indeed involves reducing titanium trichloride or titanium tetrachloride in an ether solvent like THF and under scrupulously anhydrous and oxygen-free conditions. The reducing agent initially used by McMurray was lithium aluminum hydride, but recently other chemists have introduced lithium, sodium, potassium, magnesium, zinc, zinc-copper couple, and other metals. It is not clear which reduced species of titanium is the active one. In the case of LiAlH4, a species like HTICl, complexed with THF, was isolated and shown to promote the coupling, but it is not clear that in every case the active species is a titanium-2 reagent. Thus, the mechanism that is usually written is rather vague. If we accept that the active titanium species is a titanium-2 reagent, the mechanistic scheme is shown as follows, and it is likely to involve ketol radicals, which dimerize to yield titanium pinacylates. The latter then eliminate to give E and Z olefins and some complex titanium species by an unspecified mechanism. From what we have seen so far with this reaction, it is clear that it may be limited to homocoupling reactions, as two different ketones would yield a mixture of four products, with little hope of controlling the product distribution. It is also clear that the problem of EZ isomerism is a major one, like in every other olefination reaction we will explore. Due to these difficulties, the McMurray reaction has found application primarily in intramolecular reactions, where it has been used in complex natural product synthesis. In such a situation, it is the intramolecular nature, and therefore the more favorable entropy of activation, that leads preferentially to the desired heterocoupling product, with a double bond geometry corresponding to the less strained isomer. As an example, let us highlight the synthesis of compactin, a natural cholesterol-lowering agent carried out in the group of Professor Derek Clive at the University of Alberta, Canada. This is a complex bicyclic substance featuring seven stereogenic centers, and it involves much sophisticated chemistry. The key step is an intramolecular McMurray reaction creating the bicyclic dienic structure. Clive's group carefully optimized the reaction to achieve a very good 85% yield and found that potassium on graphite was the ideal reducing agent for titanium trichloride. The diene product was then elaborated to compactin through five simple steps. The McMurray reaction is not limited to ketones and aldehydes. Other carbonyl compounds, such as esters and amides, can in some cases undergo the McMurray reaction, allowing for the synthesis of heterocycles. For example, the reaction is especially useful for building hindered indoles in good yields using the standard titanium trichloride zinc protocol. Similarly, benzofurans can also be made this way, as keto esters are also good substrates. One detail that should also be mentioned is that the McMurray reaction is uniquely suitable for the preparation of very strained olefins, meaning olefins which have four very bulky substituents. These are particularly difficult to prepare by other means. For example, olefins 1 through 3 have been prepared quite easily via the McMurray reaction. Compound 4, however, tetratert-butylethylene, has so far resisted preparation by this route or by any other means. It is an extremely strained product that perhaps may never be prepared. Due to the wide availability and versatility of carbonyl compounds, their coupling to form olefins via the McMurray reaction has found extensive use in organic synthesis and continues to enjoy synthetic extensions, as well as thorough physicochemical studies to clarify the details of its intriguing and very complex mechanism.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.